Hey guys, this is Tealus here with a new Warlords of Draenor video. In this video, I'll be looking at World of Warcraft patch 6.2. 6.2 brings a lot of new content to Warlords of Draenor. And so in this video, I would like to kind of go through all of the new content, show you what you can expect to see when 6.2 goes live, and I will even go in depth on a couple of the more important content or larger content updates to the game World of Warcraft. So, before I get into any of the new content, I want to tell you that I am not going to be looking at any class changes. Class changes are usually rather minor in World of Warcraft when it comes from patch to patch. They like to save their major changes for expansions because it's difficult to balance when you make major changes to a class in the middle of an expansion. So usually there are minor changes. I'll try and put a link below in the text that will kind of lead you to where you can take a look at major changes for your class. But otherwise, it's going to be mostly like small buff here, small nerf here for classes across the board. So the first new content of patch 6.2 for Warlords of Draenor is going to be Tanan Jungle. Tanan Jungle, we've always seen it. It's always been in there on our maps, browned out a little bit, but we've never been able to access it. Now we will be able to access it. Right now on screen, what you are seeing is I am going through the regular quest line that you will need to do to access Tanan Jungle. Tanan Jungle is very much like Isle of Thunder and Timeless Isle back in Mists of Pandaria, I think it was patch 5.2 and 5.4. Very much like those two patches, everything for this patch 6.2 will all be centralized in Tanan Jungle. Everything is going to be taking place in Tanan Jungle. It is going to be the place to be. So you have a small quest line to get there. I think it's about seven quests long. It's pretty short. I think it took me about less than 20 minutes or less to complete the quest line to get to Tanan Jungle. And when you get to Tanan Jungle is huge. It is massive. It is just as big, if not bigger, than any of the zones in Draenor so far. So there is lots of content there. There are new factions to look at. I will take a separate video and I will explore Tanan Jungle and show everything off in that video and the new factions, etc. But that is the first major content update in patch 6.2 for Warlords of Draenor. The next major content update is going to be the new garrison feature of a shipyard. A shipyard is going to be a new outlet for you to send out followers, which will be your ships, to do missions for you. Very much like your followers in your base, you send them out and do missions, they come back, bring you nice goodies and rewards. The naval missions will do the same. You will construct ships very much like the trade skill buildings inside your garrison. You build them or you set a timer for them, you give them materials, and then after some certain amount of time, a ship is built. That is how your ships will be constructed. It's going to be like work order style ship construction, I guess you could say. And you will have a fleet of ships at your command, and you will be able to send them out on missions. This is another feature that I'll go more in-depth in with a different video, but this is part of the original quest line of getting there. You build your shipyard in your quest line to get to Tanan Jungle, and once you've built your shipyard, you will build your first ship, and then from there, you can kind of do all kinds of stuff. But that will be in a different video talking about the shipyard and all of the different things you can do with ships in there. It's a new source of income, pretty much, for those of you who have been keeping up with your garrison followers. There will be a new raid in 6.2, Hellfire Citadel. It is right where Hellfire Citadel is in Hellfire Peninsula, back in Burning Crusade. So Hellfire Citadel will be there as a new raid. I'm not going to spoil any of the new bosses, but it is the next patch. I do not know if this will be the last raid tier. Blizzard has kind of hinted that there will be another raid tier after this. I don't know what it will be, but it is possible we will have a new raid tier after this. So I do not think this will be the I don't think this will be the final raid tier. But Hellfire Citadel is a very large raid, and that will be kind of the center point of this expansion. It's right in the center of Tanan Jungle. Everything that happens in this expansion is pretty much revolving around Tanan Jungle. There is a new dungeon difficulty of Mythic. So the Mythic dungeon difficulty is actually pretty cool because it kind of just gives you an extra like boost, you know, like an extra incentive to do something more difficult. You know, it's for all the people who like to like really strive for like getting to the top, and that's what the Mythic dungeon does. Mythic dungeons are on a weekly lockout, so each one of the dungeons Draenor is on a weekly lockout, and you have these dungeons will provide 685 gear, and then a boss at the end will drop 700 item gear, and you can even use your Seal of Inevitable Fate, the Seal of Inevitable, oh my gosh, Seal of Inevitable Fate. You'll be able to use these on the last boss because it drops item level 700 gear. So you'll be able to use your bonus roll currency on these ending bosses, but they do have weekly lockouts, so you will not be able to like spam them or anything. But it is a new dungeon difficulty. It's just kind of another challenge for you to go out there and try. In patch 6.2, you'll be given a new thing known as bonus events. Bonus events work very much like the old Battleground weekends in World of Warcraft, when you would have like a weekend like Alterac Valley weekend, and then we'd have a Wrathy Basin weekend. This is going to be kind of the same. They offer special rewards. So there are seven bonus events, and I'll go through each one of them with you. The first two are very interesting and a lot of fun. They are time walking events. These are two events, there are two of them, the Burning Crusade time walking and Wrath of the Lich King time walking. What happens is you will be able to queue up for an old school dungeon. For Burning Crusade, this is either the Arcatraz, Black Morass, Mana Tombs, the Shattering Halls, or Slave Pens. I don't know why they chose Black Morass, but they did. But you'll be able to queue up for one of those, and you will be able to go, and it will scale down your character's gear all the way down to 70. And you will be able to participate in that time walking event. And then when you are done, you will be able to, when you go back to level 100, when you're scaled back up to level 100 and the dungeon is done, the gear that you receive in that dungeon will also be scaled up to level 100. So you'll get gear from that. Also, during these time walking dungeons, if you complete several of them, you will get extra rewards as like a seal, etc., which isn't counted towards your weekly cap of having three seals. So you will get another bonus roll seal for doing, you know, the bonus time walking dungeons for either the Burning Crusade or Wrath of the Lich King. For the Wrath of the Lich King version, the dungeons chosen are Ankh-Het, Gundrak, Halls of Lightning, the Nexus, and Utgard Pinnacle. So those are the dungeons chosen for both Burning Crusade and Wrath of the Lich King time walking bonus event. They kind of give the same rewards. It's really great. It's just kind of an extra incentive to go do something, and it gives you know, extra loot that you wouldn't normally get. The other five are going to be just your regular Draenor dungeons, and Draenor dungeon bonus event will give you extra reputation for whatever faction you need. There's going to be the Battleground bonus event, which your characters will earn triple honor points from random battlegrounds, and if they complete the event quest, they will get 500 conquest points, which do not count towards the weekly cap. There is an arena skirmish bonus event, and characters will continue to earn triple honor points from random arena skirmish matches during this event. And then if they complete the quest for the bonus event, they will get another 500 conquest points, which do not count towards the weekly conquest cap. There is also an Apexis bonus event, which you will gain triple the amount of Apexis crystals from creatures during this bonus event. And if you complete several objectives, you will get oil, which you need oil to fuel naval missions, which I will get to in that later video. And then lastly, there is a pet battle event, which will allow you to get triple pet battle experience and give you an ultimate battle training stone if you complete the quest event that will instantly level your pet to level 25. So these events will cycle through very much like the old, like I said, like it'll cycle through like the old BG rotation that they have, but it'll appear on your calendar and you will be able to see, you know, what event will be coming up next, etc. The next major change for the patch 6.2 on Warlords of Draenor is going to be Oshrun. Now, Oshrun is another a big change that I will go through in a different video, but basically, the little mine to the left and to the right of the Alliance and Horde garrison, I guess fortifications respectively, there is a little closed mine right next to their entrance, and that has now been opened. And a large underground cavern has been added. I would say, in my opinion, it adds about 50% more space to Oshrun as a whole. So you go down there, it's a very large area. I will in a second, in another video, go down there and kind of explore it with you. And there's a lot of new changes to how Oshrun will be operating in terms of quests and experience, so that is a great new change, and I know that people will really like doing that. Because they have fixed a lot of the problems that were occurring with Horde and Alliance and ignoring each other and just doing their own thing. A lot of that has been changed, and it really will feel more like a battleground, like you will actually be forced to fight each other. The last major change to patch 6.2 is a big one. This one actually came out just today. And it regards flying. Blizzard has decided to allow flying in Warlords of Draenor. However, you are going to have to work for it, big time. You are going to have to do a series of kind of quests to achieve this. This meta achievement will be known as Draenor Pathfinder. To unlock Draenor Pathfinder, you will need to first collect 100 trainer 100 trainers 100 treasures in Draenor. So all those little treasures you kind of saw while leveling up, you will actually have to find 100 of them and go around collecting them. That is the first thing that needs to be completed. You will need to complete Draenor Lore Master, so you will need to go across the continent and do every single quest in Draenor before you can even get this flying ability in Draenor. You will need to do Securing Draenor, the achievement Securing Draenor, which is the exploration of Draenor achievement. You will need to raise all three new Tanan jungle reputations to revered. Once you have done all of these things, that's a lot of material for people to go over and do. Once you have achieved all of these items, you will be rewarded with a Rylac mount, the Soaring Sky Terror, and it is known as one of the native beasts that roam Draenor's skies. This will allow you to fly in Draenor. Everyone will be groundbound until a small follow-up patch is done. It'll be like 6.2.2 or whatever it is, depending on how many bug patches they have to have. And when that patch releases and you've completed this, you will be allowed to fly on every single character that is 90 or above. Every single character. So even if you haven't finished leveling on one of your characters in Draenor, you will be able to as soon as you have completed this meta achievement. So that is a great change. I know a lot of people, liked having no flying. I personally liked having no flying, but I started to see where people were coming from when you wouldn't be able to see it. So I'm glad they're releasing it later. I do not know if Tanan Jung, you if you will be able to fly through Tanan Jungle. I think it's a better idea for, Tanan Jungle to kind of, like, whatever the major hub is for whatever patch is, to remain groundbound, but it's possible that you may be able to fly out in Tanan Jungle. But they are actually going to allow flying in this patch. So that is the last major change. It came out just today. They announced it. So it's a big change. So there are a lot of changes in World of Warcraft for the new content patch of 6.2. It's going to be a lot of fun. There will be a lot of changes to make things a lot more fun and enjoyable. I will go through in separate videos and take a look at Tanan Jungle, the shipyard and naval missions, and then Oshrun. So those will be in three separate videos, but otherwise that is everything dealing with Draenor, patch 6.2 in Warlords of Draenor. So I hope you guys enjoyed all of this. I hope to see you guys out in Draenor. Otherwise, I will see you guys later. Teal us out.